It means everything. It's who I am. And a lot of people don't really understand how deeply rooted I am in the SWATs. But I was there even before I went to Mays High School, hanging out at Greenbrier Mall at the age of 9, 10, 11, 12, every single Saturday, going to Westgate to the movies, going to Greenbrier to the movies. We even had another movie theater down the street, headed towards Ben Hill. So we stumped all those streets for so many years. It's who I am. It's ingrained in me. So we are very proud. We'll start there. We're very proud of Southwest Atlanta. Don't really care what anyone else thinks about our being proud of Southwest Atlanta, but we're rich in history. We're rich in education. So many of my neighbors are extremely educated. I always tell people that I am the least educated person that I know. And I have a college degree because it is so important that people understand where we come from, the importance of education in our community has really been there. That's why it's so important that we bring APS up to standards now. Because I know what good education does for a community. I see it every day in our elders and our middle-aged people. I'm not saying that's me, but I am saying that I know what education does for communities. And I think that's what makes us as proud as we are. You know, just digging in civically and education-wise, and it's never about money, not in Southwest Atlanta. It's about history and being rich in education and love. We really do care about one another. I grocery shop with people that I've known forever, all the time, including yesterday. That's what'll make us better, is if the people that know the real true qualities that you get from having a great education, from being in Atlanta Public Schools, if we dig in and give back, that's what it takes. I actually grew up in University Plaza. My parents hung out in the birdcage. I went to E.A. Ware on what at the time was called Hunter Street, is now MLK. That is definitely still Southwest Atlanta, and it's going to be the next YMCA headquarters. That was Edmund Asa Ware. I went there from first grade through fifth grade. So, I just know that it really does take a community. I took full advantage of before school programs and after school programs. I would eat cheese grits in the morning at school. I rode MARTA to school from my mother's office, and she was working at Westlake at the Job Corps Center for the whole time I was in elementary school and high school. You know, elementary was K through 7. Yeah. And high school. She was at Westlake at the Job Corps Center. So I just know that it takes the community to help. So APS can't do it by itself. We really have to give them the tools they need. We have to give the parents the training they need. We have to offer the children programs. I took advantage of all programs because I was with a working mom. And so I'm on council. Every time I hear of a need, I'm there to help. I'm like, of course, the answer is yes. So I think that's what it takes. Yeah, and I think it's all been very organic, believe it or not. I don't think you grow up in the SWATs thinking, I'm going to live over here because I want to be the mayor. I don't think you think, this week I want to be a Delta Airlines retiree, and next week I think I'm just gonna run for council. That's just not how it works. You see the need, and then you know you can help. So you jump in and ask for people to support you in that help. And that's how it happened for me. I think that's how it happened for most of the people that have gone on to be very successful in a political career. Like, I still don't consider myself a politician, believe it or not. I just don't. Like, I would think that if you would ask some of the other people that have gone to do huge justice fighting and civic fighting and civil awareness, and like Andy Young, Ambassador Young, and John Lewis, they would never consider themselves politicians because they were helping out, right? Mm-hmm. They were doing what was right at the time, and it just rolled into whatever it is today. And that's what it really is from Southwest Atlanta. I don't think that it was our formula. I think that we just raise our games to take care of people. So my hopes and dreams for the SWATs, it's quite simple. I hope that we have a quality of life that's good for everyone. I want to be able to walk out of my door and walk on beautiful sidewalks to the Cascade Springs Nature Preserve, all the way there. I want to be able to catch a nice MARTA train if I want to on Campbellton Road. That will take me to great events. I want to be able to use Greenbrier Mall as like Southwest Atlanta's downtown, you know, the beautiful anchor that it is. I want to be able to make sure that the YMCA's membership is way up, because that programming for youth is just, you know, is unsurpassable. Like, if we can get that done, that'll be great for everyone. I want to make sure that the parents understand how important it is for us to really nurture our children and take a second look sometimes to make sure you help another child. I just want to make sure our quality of life is good and that we get to eat outside at restaurants. Really simple things. I don't think that I want it to be anything more than what I've seen it be in the past. But I want to make sure that we have a nice quality of life in Southwest Atlanta.
Okay, thank you.